Hello, Periscope. Hello, hello, hello. One of you that are tuning in Periscope, the man of God is with you one more time. It's a pleasure to be with you. All of you that are in Periscope, tune in right now. Waiting for you to get in Periscope, waiting for you to come over and Periscope, all of you. Please share this video. Please share this video. Today I believe God is about to do something new in every one of your life. Hope you can hear me clearly. God bless you. And thank you one more time that we are live in Periscope right now. God bless you. Thank you that are tuning in. Thank you all that are tuning in. Today we actually I just use Pentecostal Fire because we are living in the last days, and Pentecost can be repeated, and we understand that our experience also can be Pentecostal Fire. It can actually fell at you at any moment, any second. Anytime you can receive the power of Pentecost. The Bible tells us that on the day of Pentecost, we're going to read Acts chapter 2. It actually told us about the day of Pentecost. It told us how the fire of God have come and consumed everything that wasn't of God and released the disciple to preach the gospel in power and in might and in the word of God. And so today we want to deal with Pentecost, because many folks forget about Pentecost. They don't remember the basic. And so I just want to elaborate a little on Pentecost, and we'll talk about it, because the Bible reminds us about Pentecost. So we're going to talk about Pentecost. And so we're going to read from Acts chapter 2, and we're going to read. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. So first, we got to get in one accord. Do you believe that God can heal you? For God to heal you, we all have to be in one accord. Do you believe that God can give you a breakthrough? We got to be on one accord. And also they was in one place. But because of the invisible God, we don't have to be at the same place for God to move, because God is everywhere. But they was in one accord. And it can say same place. Their mind was in heaven. Their mind was thinking about the same thing. They want the Pentecostal fire of God. And so today, ladies and gentlemen, we must be hungry and thirsty for this Pentecostal fire to change our life and to bring us to a higher dimension in God. You know, many of us stop grow spiritually. It simply means that when we stop grow spiritually, we only stay in one level. Do you know that God wants you to be more than in one level? God wants you to be high in the spirit, and God also wants you to balance it out, that you will still in the natural sometime, but you will walk in the spirit. So is a natural man that mix with the supernatural, is a man that is walking in the flesh, but he's not just flesh, he's spirit and flesh. And so we must understand that God wants us to be spirit and flesh. If we just speak about earthly stuff, nothing will change. I believe God want to release a Pentecostal fire that will change your life, that will transform your life. So listen, and suddenly, this is verse 2, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing, yes, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. So we got to understand the wind is sound like a mighty rushing wind. But what was in the wind? It wasn't just wind alone. Because we right now I'm in the house and the wind is blowing outside. But that's just natural wind. But the wind that came from heaven, it was a Holy Ghost wind. That wind that came from heaven transformed the disciple life. That wind that came from heaven gave them a consolation that Jesus is real. Because some of them have doubt in their self. Because Jesus told them to wait up in the upper room and they shall be filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. Ladies and gentlemen, we need that power to lay upon us from the crown of our head to the sole of our feet. We need that power that will transform our life, that power that will change our heart, that power that will make us care again, that power that will make us have compassion, that power that will make us see again, that power that will make us believe God again. Because some of us have lost our faith in our Creator and the Creator of creation. Many folks have lost their faith, and so you got to ask God, I want a Pentecostal touch. I want a touch that's going to change the world. I want a touch that's going to change me. I want a touch that's going to change my mind. And give me a Pentecostal touch, oh God, because I cannot keep on going on without you. I cannot keep on living without you. So you got to ask God for a Pentecostal touch. And there appear, oh yes, unto them cloven tongue like as fire, and it sit upon each of them. So when the Holy Ghost come, it make you speak in tongue. Okay, the Holy Ghost make you speak in tongue. That's the evidence that God is speaking through you. A tongue is a heavenly language, and no man can understand tongue but God. So if they see you speaking in tongue, they know that that's not earthly language, because man understand earthly stuff, but man don't understand heavenly stuff. That's why on the day of Pentecost, when the disciples start to speak in heavenly language, what these men said, they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongue as the Spirit gave them utterance. So it was the Spirit that in control. You know, many times they are teaching folks to speak in tongue. They are teaching folks how to speak to God. You can't teach nobody. The Holy Ghost will teach you. And you get, when you receive Jesus, you will receive the Spirit too. Because once you receive Jesus, you open the door to say, come in Jesus and fill me up with your power. Fill me up with your presence. And so, ladies and gentlemen, once you receive the Spirit, tongue is a language. Tongue is a heavenly language. Tongue is not an earthly language. No man can interpret tongue unless they got a spiritual connection. You only can interpret tongue that is heavenly language if you connect it to a spiritual God. So I don't know why folks is telling you or teaching you to speak in tongue. It cannot happen like that. God move when he want to move, and you don't have to speak in nobody tongue. You just gotta speak how God wants you to speak, and God is the God of all language. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you, when the Holy Ghost come, there must be evidence. Somehow, somewhere, there must be evidence. So a lot of folks that saying, I received the Spirit of God, and don't preach you, that let us know that they didn't receive it. Because the Bible said, when the Spirit come, the Spirit of truth, it shall lead you into what? All truth. All truth, the Spirit shall lead you. Not only that, the Spirit shall lead you into all truth, the Spirit shall guide you, the Spirit shall protect you, the Spirit shall lead you the way of God. The Spirit is not contradict God, because the Spirit is God himself dwelling in man. So you got to understand, when folks contradict their word, are they contradicted their word and saying the Bible say this when the Bible didn't say it, they are not a child of God, they are antichrist. The Bible said there are many antichrists that are in the world right now. That's what John said. If you read 1 John and 2 John, it told you about the antichrist that is now in the world. That means there is a lot of antichrist, ladies and gentlemen, that is now in the world that is rejecting God, rejecting the word of God, and doing what they want to do. Any man that don't confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, they are antichrist. Any man that said, like preacher that is saying, there is one more than one way to get to God, the devil is a liar. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man coming to the Father except they come through me. For you to get to God, you got to go through Jesus. Jesus is the only way that you will make it to heaven and ever make it to heaven is by going through the blood, because it's only the blood that can wash you and purify you. You got to understand that for in the Old Testament, for man to connect with God, they gotta send up a sacrifice and slay a lamb and use the blood. You gotta understand in the New Testament, that was the lamb that was slain, that was Christ Jesus. And so when God look up on us, he don't see us, he see the blood. He don't see Jesus, he only see the blood, because God only can respond or only can connect to blood sacrifice. So you got to understand why Jesus died on the cross. When God look up on us today, he don't see us, he see the blood of Jesus. He don't see your mess, he see the blood, because the blood already pay every price that you might redeem. So I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, you are not trying to be saved, you are saved. Once you accept Jesus and accept salvation and repent from your sin and get the Holy Ghost fire, you are saved. You ain't trying to be saved. No devil can take you out of the hands of God. You are in the hands of God. And if God predestinate you to be with him, I don't care what hell you go through, you are saved. You can go through the fire, you are saved. Go through the flood, you are saved. Go through depression, you are saved. Go through bandage, you are saved. Locked up behind bar, you are saved. The enemy turn your life upside down, you are saved. And when you overcome these little tribulation that the devil is trying to throw at you, you're going to look the devil in his face and say, I count these as light tribulation. I count it all joy. Why? Because whatever you put in me, devil can't kill me. Because whatever you put in me, Jesus already died for it. So if you're trying to put sickness in me, Jesus already swallowed sickness. If you're trying to put death in me, Jesus already take away the key from death. So whatever you're trying to do, devil, it won't work. Because when the day of Pentecost came, the Holy Ghost release and the children of God receive it. And so all of us that receive it today, we got Pentecostal fire. So I can tell the devil, I don't care what you do with my mama, my sister, my brother, you can't stop me from praising God, because you can't do nothing with me if God don't allow you to do it. So come on, devil, do whatever you want to do, because I must be saved. I'm going to heaven. I don't care how much fire come. I don't care how much flood come. I don't care how much depression come. I don't care how much financial difficult come. I don't care what you do, devil. I'm saved. I'm approved by God. I'm blood washed. I'm blood sanctified. I'm blood purified. I'm caught up in the blood. I'm wrapped up in the blood. I'm tied up in the blood. I'm safe up in the blood. I'm all up in the blood of Jesus. So don't matter what the devil do to me, I got one word to tell the devil: you can't touch the blood. The blood is so pure that anytime you come beside the blood, demons start tremble, because the blood of Jesus will never lose his power. Buddha gonna lose his power. A Muhammad gonna lose his power. I don't care who you call yourself. If you don't accept Jesus and you worship Haile Selassie, they gonna lose their power. But one person will never lose their power. It's the blood of Jesus. The blood that washed you. I don't care how deep you was in sin. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. Some of you was dope addict. Some of you was crackhead. Some of you was prostitute. Some of you was liar. Some of you was blasphemer. Did not the blood came for you? Did not the blood pull you out of hell? Did not the blood redeem you? Did not the blood save you? Why are you letting the devil telling you that there ain't power in the blood? Did not the blood came way down in hell and get you down in hell? Why you was broken down? Why you was tired? Why you was depressed? Why the enemy oppressed you? Did not the blood of Jesus came down there and snatch you and take you out and said, come to glory, Okoshimasa, and said, devil, lift up your heads and look up to the holy King of glory, because there is a king that is powerful, that is mighty, that is greater than your weapon and your strategy. Oh, Jesus, I've paid all at Calvary. Jesus, I've taken away my sin. Jesus, I've kept me in perfect peace. Jesus, I've paid my bill. Jesus, I've paid my light bill. Thank God for Jesus. Jesus, I've died for me. Thank God that I got a Pentecostal fire that no other fire can take it out. You ain't talking about me. Throw me in the fire furnace that can't take out this fire. Throw me in the lion den that can't take out this fire. Put me in the higher apartments like John that can't take out this fire. This is a saving fire. This is a Holy Ghost fire. This is a power fire. This is a burning fire. This is a consuming fire. No devil from hell can stop this fire. The fire of Jesus will break every chain. The fire of Jesus will break every yoke. The fire of Jesus will set you free from heavy captivity. I want you to tell God, fall afresh in me. Let me feel Pentecostal fire. Hallelujah. So Pentecostal fire came, and there were dwelling at Jerusalem the Jews, the devoted man. And when they hear Pentecostal fire abroad, when they hear shouting, when they hear praising, when they hear dancing, they say, what's going on? This preacher ain't Methodist. This preacher is full of fire. This preacher ain't regular. We've been to the synagogue and we see preacher, but this preacher is carrying fire. What's going on? They start to laugh and say, these men are drunk. Peter said, no, not so. And the day of Pentecost, let me tell you what Joel said. In the last days, God shall pour out his spirit and all flesh. Your young man shall prophesy. Your old man shall dream. Your son and your daughter shall see vision. That's Pentecostal fire. Pentecostal fire cannot be stopped. It cannot be stopped by dog. It cannot be stopped by enemy. It cannot be stopped by the adversary. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to close up my sermon now, but I feel the power of Pentecost. One day, the apostle Peter, before he came, the apostle Paul, before he was Saul, he said, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to try to stop this Pentecostal fire. What Paul was doing, he was persecuting the children of God and said, hey, I'm going to stop them from preaching. Hey, I'm going to stop them from calling in Jesus. Hey, I'm going to stop them from talking about the creator of creation. Hey, they don't got the real God, because Paul was one of the Pharisee of the law, didn't know Pentecostal fire. Paul went on the road of Damascus, got a letter from the high priest, said, anybody that called and Pentecostal fire, I'm going to put them in handcuffs. I'm going to send them to jail. I'm going to bring them back to Jerusalem. Listen what happened to Paul. Paul
Saul was going down the road of Damascus, and the Bible said, suddenly Pentecostal fire shine out of heaven, oh Koshiba. And when it shine out of heaven, somebody, it touched Paul, knock him down in his feet, knock him down in his face. Paul repent from his sin and said, oh Lord, what do you have me to do? Pentecostal fire told Paul, it's hard to kick against the prick, it's hard to fight against God, it's hard to go against the will of God. I got a work for you, Paul. You must preach the gospel. Paul, I got a work for you. Paul's eyes went blind because he tried to fight against Pentecostal fire. Hallelujah. Try to fight. So, I'm getting out of here. But the Bible said, and he fell to the earth, and hear a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, Okoshima, why persecute thou me? Okay, our persecutest, thou me. And he said, who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, oh my God, who thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the prick. Oh my God, you can't fight against Pentecostal fire. And he trembling and astonished and said, Lord, what will thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. You want to know what Paul did? Paul will read, go down to Acts chapter 9 and verse 20. And straightway he preached Jesus Christ in the synagogue, that he is the Son of God. That's what Pentecostal fire do. When Paul get Jesus, he started preaching to the Jews and said, Jews, you got it wrong. I got connection with Pentecostal fire. I want to tell you that anything that you need in this time, you must ask God to fill you up. Fill you up with his power. Fill you up with Pentecostal fire. Fill up your mind with the Holy Ghost. Fill up your tongue with the Holy Ghost. Fill up your belly. Out of your belly, something shall come. It shall hit the hurt. And when it hit the hurt, there shall be a move of God. They said, we got to kill Paul. We got to get rid of Paul. He's preaching Pentecostal fire. Ladies and gentlemen, they said, kill him. The Jews said, we got to kill him. I'm trying to tell you, you can't stop it. You can't block it. You can't get rid of it. You can't hold it out. You can't cut it. You can't trim it. It's hot. It's turning up. It's fire. It's going to save. It's going to redeem. It's going to set free. I need you to receive Pentecostal fire. Glory be to God. Pentecostal fire. Fill me again, Lord. You need that. Because in this time, the world need Pentecostal fire. Fall afresh in me. Okoshima Suta. Fall afresh power. Hey God. That will break the yoke of darkness. Fall afresh Pentecostal fire. In a long time I don't hear a preacher talk about Pentecostal fire. Because Pentecostal fire, it lets soul get saved. What are you talking about, man of God? I gotta go back to Acts chapter 2. I gotta go back over there. Because now we are preaching, and the Bible said, and the day of Pentecost, that there was over what? 3,000 souls was saved. So when the Pentecostal fire came, something happened. What happened? The Bible said that Peter, when the fire came, Peter said, hey man of Galilee, oh Shaba, repent from all your sin. Oh yes, Lord. And they turned, their heart was pricked. And they said, oh yes. Now when they hear this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter, what to the rest of the apostle, man and brethren? Oh yes. What shall we do? Listen what Peter said to them. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus for the remission of sin.
Oh, yes.
And he shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Oh, yes.
So when you repent, you will receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
It's real.
And be baptized. Folks don't talk about this no more. You don't hear folks talk about Pentecost of fire no more. They're just talking about everything else. But what you need is fire, child. Fire to consume. Fire to burn out everything that don't belong in you. Fire to keep you holy. Well, today we're going to pray that Pentecostal fire will release in you. Church need it. The apostle did have it. The prophet, they came in it. Hallelujah. And Jesus walked in fire. When Jesus came on earth, he was moving in fire. His word was fire. They was quick. They burned. They cut. They deliver. Hallelujah. Pentecostal fire. Pentecostal fire. We're going to pray. You need it. I said you need it. You need Pentecostal fire. You need it. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for Pentecostal fire. The fire that keep us running. The fire that keep us dancing. The fire that keep us preaching. Father, today in the name of Jesus, fall afresh in your people. Fall afresh anointing and them from the crown of their head. To the sole of their feet, O God. God, help them to reconnect with you. Regenerated. Reconcile them back to you, God. In this hour, they need that fire. They need that word. They need that present. They need that glory. They need a fresh anointing. Fresh anointing. You know what happened? Many times, amen. Many times, it feel like God is not around. Many times you are praying and even preaching and even by yourself, it feel like God is not there. But every now and then, you got to tell God, give me some Pentecostal fire that keep burning. That I might preach your word with fire. You need that fire. You need that fire. You need that fire. God, touch your children. So many are depressed. What they need is not the gospel of prosperity. They need a fire. Fire. Give them Pentecostal fire. A Pentecost fire. Pentecostal. Pentecost fire in them. In the name of Jesus. On the day of Pentecost, there was fire. Receive it. Run with it. Praise God for it. Live on with it. Tell the devil, I got fire. I got so much fire that you can't stop me, devil. This is fire that Jesus have sent. And ain't no witch gonna stop the Pentecostal fire. God bless you. Want to tell you that God have you in his plan. Praise God for that. Thank you all of you, Periscope. I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you. God bless you. Receive that Pentecostal fire. Receive it. And be blessed. Yes, you need that. All of you need it. All of you need it. Every one of us need Pentecostal fire. God bless you, angels. C917. Yeah, God bless you, whatever the number is at the end. God bless you. We need it. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless.